I'd do a quick review on a little plugin, actually. I was given a plugin by a developer to like check it out, give it a review, see what's going on. And it's pretty cool. It's a it's called the 10X plugin, and it's by Typewriter Software. And it's a dynamic stereo imager with a couple of little extra bonuses. So let me show you what's going on with it here. So this is, of course, Reason. I've got a bit of a track going here, kind of a, I don't know what you call it, whatever, it's whatever spews forth. Yeah, let's try it on like one thing in general. I was thinking at first glance, I was thinking like maybe a kick drum. The kick drum is right here. There's the guy. And of course we can, you know, head on over there with our rack and do some wiring. So probably the easiest way to just process the kick separately is to run it into another mixer channel. So grab our utilities, which I did not click, so and then mix channel, boink, and we'll call it kick drum, and then we'll go output of, which sound was this? This is number, just pad one. Okay, so we'll go audio out 3 and 4 into that thing, and then we have to route that guy to audio out 3 and 4. So drum output 3 and 4. There we go. So that should be kicking in the kick drum. Yeah. All right. So now we can, of course, hook up an insert effect, and the insert effect. Yeah, under there it is. The 10X. It's got a cool look to it, I suppose. Kind of, I don't know. It's almost old school, I guess. It's like a giant vault door. You know. Well, let's solo this first of all. Okay, so there it is. So you basically turn the giant vault knob. And if you notice, you have to really listen carefully to the mono or the stereo like presentation of a signal. So like, if it's really kind of sitting directly between your ears like this, then of course that's mono. Anytime you take a mono signal and you change the timing of it, even the slightest, I mean, we're talking milliseconds or microseconds here, between what's happening in the left and right ear, then it kind of becomes stereo. Okay, so that's basically what a program like this does, what most stereo imaging does. It puts a really tiny amount of delay on either end of the signal, and it kind of gives it, you know, it takes what's ever here in the front, and it pushes it out to the sides. So we're talking about the stereo field here. This is not like a big, flashy, cool effect, but it is really cool, actually, in terms of how it works and how it can change, you know, certain components of your sound. So like here, we turn it up. Okay, not much difference. Hyperdrive does a big thing. Okay, well, let's try it on something else then, because I have a feeling it's because the sort of like the content of all that stuff, the harmonic content, it doesn't change much because it doesn't. It's just a kick drum, right? So it's like the same thing over and over. So, like, how is this program going to, dynamically? automatically change something based on the harmonic content of it when there is no difference. So that might be what's going on. Well, you know, we'll try it out. That's the kind of the point of this video. Giving it a shot, seeing what's going on. It seems to be stable. I've played with it a little bit, of course, so far. Things seem to run well. That if I didn't have as many sounds going, if it was a simpler track, like maybe just kick and snare, you could probably turn it up a lot more than that. I think because of the complexity that I have in this drum track, not to say that it's super complex, but you know, there's a lot of things going on in there, a lot of little percussion noises and stuff. I think that's giving it a little bit of too much stereo presence, I think. Yeah, probably. So. Let's try this hyperdrive thing. So the hyperdrive engages the attack and the release time. Okay. So you can kind of get a ducking. So I'm curious as to how this is going to sound if I just incorporate it in my mix like normally with everything else. So let me hear it one more time without. All right, so there's without. It definitely gives those drums a lot of presence, just a little bit. Okay, so let's try something then. Let's bypass aux effects there, and then let's listen to the whole. Sort of like the whole track a little bit. Let me try this on that bass too. So, okay, unbypass. Okay, that is cool. That is really cool. Hear that again. The drums are kind of like, especially that clap snare thing. Say that with almost anything like this, less is more. Remember that, less is more. You can't probably just put it on your entire mix. That would do weird things. So like, you really need your music grounded in a mono. Like you gotta have some stuff in the middle in order to notice the stuff that's flown to the outsides. So if you're really trying to create like a good stereo field, you need to actually think about that. Like, it's frequencies, you know, low stuff here, high stuff here, and it's over time. Okay, yeah. But then you also have the stereo image. So things that are in the middle, things that are on the outsides, things are panned left, maybe panned right. You know, there's a lot of stuff going on. And this is an interesting little thing. It just kind of like, it just makes the sound more exciting to the stereo field, which is really, really cool. So I'm going to try it on a few other things and you know, see what happens here. I think I'll try it on that bass and then I'll maybe, you know, call this video a day. Of course, I'll leave a link in the description and things like that below. So let's find my bass sound right there. Let's see, what is it? This is this guy right here. Yes. There's the red track. There, that is it. Now, of course, with Thor, you've got a chorus. So I'm gonna turn that off for now because the chorus tends to do, I don't want to say the same thing, but similar things in terms of how it pans things right and left and does some stuff to it. So sounds like it enhances the mid-range-ish stuff and throws it right and left and maybe puts a little delay on either channel. So here, let me hear it without. So there it is without. There it is with a lot. I guess, unfortunately, it sounds like it kind of messes a little bit with the EQ. Takes out a little bit of the bass. So if we fire this up, but maybe that's okay. So bypassing. So I don't know if you noticed what I did there. I turned on the chorus. So let's hear it with chorus. So this is without. And that's with. Interesting. Okay. So with the chorus on the Thor, it has a lot more effect. So I'm going to turn the chorus off. All right. And then kind of give you again the before and after. So here it is without. There it is with. Seemingly no effect. Okay, we'll turn chorus on. Do the same thing. And now it has a big effect. Interesting. Of course, we can hyperdrive and we can kind of pump it a little bit. I'm not really a fan of that sound for this. This is my bass. Gotta have my bass. Seems like a cool little plugin. Again, I'll leave a link in the description below. Thanks for watching, and if you like the video, give me a like, give me a thumbs up, give me a subscription, maybe. I put out all kinds of random stuff. Some of it's gaming, some of it's music, some of it's whatever. So, thanks for watching, and we will see you later.